Hello everybody, welcome to Life Uncommon. We are live here in the studios of Plus TV. My name is Andrea Rodriguez.
And I'm Alita Sharp, and we are so excited to be with you this morning and very excited about the show we have coming up.
Yeah, we're kind of twinning this
morning. I noticed that. That hasn't happened in a while.
I know. Great minds think alike.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah.
So, but like you said, we are excited about this show. It's been we've been talking about it and arranged it a few weeks or more than a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
But I'm very happy because they came a long way to be with us this morning.
Yes, they did.
And this is a show where we want to highlight and just really promote amazing business owners who are so creative and are putting all their love into the products that they make.
Yes, at Belizean business owners.
Yes. Authentic.
Yes.
So we are excited to have with us this morning, and we are jumping straight into this because we want to give her as much time as possible to just talk about the different pieces. And she also made some pieces for us to give away.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm excited.
I'm
about
hoping
that.
I could keep one. But if you don't call in, I'm keeping it. All right. So, but this morning we have with us Sharondale Humes. Are you from Borrelboom?
Yes.
From Borrelboom.
Oh.
All right. That's a back in my neck of the woods. I'm not from Borrelboom, but it's close by. So welcome to Life Uncommon.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being with us.
Tell us a little bit about yourself for all the people that are viewing this morning.
Okay, well, my name is Sharondale Humes. Mm-hmm. And as you said, I live in Borrelboom. Born and grown. Mm-hmm. Yes, I am a wife of 24 years.
Wow.
Four children, ages 10, 16, 20, and 23.
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Yes. She looks way too young. I never would have guessed any of that.
Thank you. Yes, ma'am. Yes. I'm also a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And I fellowship at Divine Ministries in Belize City.
Okay.
Yes, and I'm also a singer musician.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
So those are on top of my, who I am.
Yes, very talented.
I remember you singing and playing the guitar in that little church in Birmingham Landing, the Baptist church there when I was growing up, you see, and she doesn't look that old, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
All right, so when did you start out? Was this something that you always loved to do, or what? When did you start? Like, I'm sure you started playing around with stuff at first before you got serious about it.
Well, to be honest with you, when I started, it wasn't with doing jewelry.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I've been doing this a little over 9 years.
Okay.
But just before this, I was making those wicker type chairs.
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay.
For 8 years.
Oh, wow.
And just doing things with my hands, I've always loved doing that.
Yeah.
And so when I started to do this, it was actually a gift that I had given a lady in my village.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And she had encouraged me and said, why don't you try and do small things and go to the marketplace, and especially the tourist village. And I argued with her a number of times. I said, I don't have any idea of what to make.
Uh-huh.
But as I thought about it, and she also gave me a box of coconut shells.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so the first thing that came to me was to do leaves. I love leaves.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So I drew leaves onto the coconut shells.
Okay.
And I started with a hacksaw blade to cut with. Hmm. And that's how it started. I found out.
Wait, with a hacksaw?
Yes.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, my hands had corn.
Yes.
Yes. And step by step, what I did, I just gathered more shells, and I drew other designs, and I started to do a layaway to get a machine that can cut the shell.
Okay.
So that took some time as well.
Yeah.
But I would say within the first 3 months or so, ideas just started to flow, and I would draw them, and you know, it would be an excitement for me just to wake up in the morning to go in my shop and to see if I can bring these ideas to life.
Yeah.
So that's how it started. Mm-hmm. And she had also encouraged me to visit the resort that was right there in my village.
Right. Okay.
Uh-huh. The Orchid Resort.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I approached the owner one day if I could come and, you know, set up at his place. And he said, well, yes, you can. The only thing is that whatever you bring here, it has to be that you made it.
Okay.
So I said, no problem. So I went there and I sat there for, I think, the first 2 days out of the week, and I sold nothing. Actually, it was a cartoon box that I turned into a table.
Okay.
You know, there wasn't a wooden table or anything, but that was the beginning of, you know, what I have now.
Uh-huh.
And I think within 4 months or so, I built my table.
Okay.
And I had the table filled with about 9 different products.
Uh-huh.
And within the year, it multiplied to 3 tables.
Wow. Okay.
Wow.
And it was just different ideas and products that I did. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what kept you going, though? Because, you know, sometimes I think one of the things with us as women and Belizeans, we kind of get discouraged. Mm-hmm. And after that couple of days of sitting out there, you know,
and not selling anything.
Like, what did you tell yourself? What was going through your mind to say, okay, you know, I'm still going to press through, I'm still going to try?
Okay. Well, besides all this, I'm someone that seek God on my decisions before I make steps, and this was a big step for me.
Yes, it was.
Because I love being a housewife.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I would say I have been a housewife done. You know, I love that.
Yeah.
And just coming out of that to say go in the marketplace was not a vision or dream of mine. So I had to pray about this all along the way before stepping out. And the Lord gave me a scripture reference in Matthew 27. He was 27. But it's that story of the parable of the ones that he gave talents.
The talents,
yes, he gave that to me, and I knew that was a word exactly for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I took it very seriously, and I said, I want to make God proud.
Yes.
You know, he was sharing with me, they gave me this gift. And so I'm thinking I would have to stand before him and give account of what I do with it. And so honestly, that was the foundation. And besides that was prayer. My friend, she also is my manager within the business itself.
When
I'm there, has been very, very important in those early days, especially in my life. Because many days I would go home and in tears and crying, you know, and she would come and pray with me because I would want to give up. So it wasn't easy. Honestly, it was not easy. I wanted to quit. I would have quit many days had she not encouraged me and prayed with me.
Wow.
I would have quit, because it's not like I went into any training or anything.
Right, So how does your husband and children, how do they feel about the business?
Oh, they're all proud of me as well. And they assist in any way that they can.
Okay, that's what I was going to ask.
Very, very supportive.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm really happy that you shared that, though, because I know there are other women out there, housewives, like myself, you know, who have a talent, they have that gift that God has given to them, but they're afraid to step out, or they do step out but they're stumbling and they don't have that support system. So I'm really glad that you shared that you had somebody that would come and pray with you and encourage you. I think that is a key,
a very important key.
But let us go and maybe look at some of the pieces, and then we could continue our conversation. Everything, guys, that you see on this table is made or was made by Sharondale, like everything.
Designed and made,
I want care for a lot of things, you know? And my husband stepped into this studio and the pressure was on, you know? Because I like to tease him, because he said somebody used to say, a wife used to tell her husband whenever he came home on payday, handsome, and would stretch her hands out, right? So I might have to go, handsome. All right, but we have three, actually, beautiful ladies who are going to be modeling some of the pieces. We have two on the set right now, and we will bring the other one on in a little while, Carla,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So we have Kelsey and Rocio.
Uh-huh.
So Sharondale, maybe you could describe and tell us a little bit about the pieces they are wearing.
Okay. Well, the pieces that she's wearing is from coconut shell.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I use the dry coconut that is brown and the young coconut that is lighter.
Okay.
So just combine both of it together. I call it like a teardrop.
Yes, that's beautiful.
Yes.
Absolutely beautiful. And then those are beads?
Yes,
on the
I
necklace?
Use glass beading and the wooden bead in between.
Mm. Okay. Gorgeous.
I like Rocio one.
I know, I like Rocio's one, the heart.
Yes, so Rocio, she's wearing a piece from my mosaic line.
Okay.
And actually, it's underneath, if you can lift it, underneath is bamboo.
Oh.
Yes, and I combine it with, I combine the other side with broken coconut pieces.
Oh, wow, that is beautiful.
And again, with glass beads and wood along there.
Okay.
Yes.
And what's the little clasp that's holding it on, the little, is that silver or
no,
what's
no,
that?
No, ma'am, that, it just looks like silver.
Yeah, that's really pretty.
Thank you.
That's really pretty.
Yeah. I speechless today. I'm kind of like, I just look at like,
I know.
But it's, yeah. Okay, and so then, if we could have Carla come on, and
yes.
then we could, before
oh,
Carla
yes.
comes on, yes.
Kelsey
yes.
has
Kelsey
a
has
bracelet
on a bracelet.
It's really yes. gorgeous.
Kelsey yes. just passed the bracelet over this side.
Yeah. Just turn your hand a little more. There we go.
Yes, again, it is from coconut shell. And the thing about coconut shell is that they have different shades.
Uh-huh.
So I look for those ones that has the different shades in it.
Yeah.
And again, with the wooden beads on the
yes. okay.
side of it.
Beautiful.
So Kelsey, the cameraman wants you to do something with your hands. Just imagine at the pump. Price is right,
that's
you know?
Right, yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
It has one of those clasps that you can do by yourself.
Uh-huh.
So to call someone to help you.
Yeah, here,
turn
on the,
over.
Turn your
bottom.
Your wrist over mm-hmm. so we can see the clasp.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah. All right.
But I like that you can do it yourself, because
yes.
sometimes that's so hard when you're trying to put on jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
I like it that you can do it
yes,
yourself.
Yes, I always struggle with that. So, and for the viewers at home, you guys, the camera really isn't doing it justice.
No.
You know, they are, and I'm not a cameraman. It's, you know, it's just, the stuff really, it looks way better than it does on the TV, for sure. All right, so we're going to have the girls put on some more pieces to show you guys. We want you guys to get a good feel of what these pieces look like wearing them. And if you guys want to start screenshotting, you know, pieces
yeah.
you want your husband to get for you, or maybe you want to buy a piece for a friend, your mom, your sister, these would make excellent gifts that will last for a long time. Oh
yes.
My goodness.
So now we have Carla.
Now Carla, she has to come on.
Oh my goodness.
Yes. Oh,
goodness. No, these are my favorite pieces.
I think Alida and I make you go home with that. Okay.
Yeah, this is
so tell
gorgeous.
Us about this.
Okay, so the piece that Carla is wearing, it's my one of my signature pieces. Again,
okay.
it's the mosaic line, coconut shell. And the earring, it's again,
yes.
behind it's bamboo,
yeah.
coconut pieces on front. I did a project with Unique Belize. I don't know if you've heard of
yes.
Unique.
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh. They do like trophies and different pieces
that's
like that.
That's a different.
That's a different.
Oh, okay.
So you have two Unique Belize.
Okay.
Because
yes.
I know of one up the road from here.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Okay. Now
all
this,
right.
This was a project that Niche and the government of Belize.
Okay.
Yes, and BTB, you know, had all come together.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
We launched it, I think it was about a year and a half to two
okay.
years ago. So I was the local coordinator for that project,
okay.
working with 30 other artisans.
Okay.
And so we all had to design a piece that we carried that brand, a unique Belize brand.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's the name. And so this was the piece that I designed that project.
Mm-hmm. The necklace and the earrings?
And the earrings.
Yeah.
Yes. And then I see bracelets.
I know, you too. Uh-huh.
So the thing with bamboo, you know, you can get it any size. So, uh-huh. You know, if someone should order the bamboo.
Extra small.
Okay.
Yes, I can make it any size. And it also goes along with the others that are in front. Mm-hmm. It's just the different shapes and sizes that I can do with it.
And how would you go about, how do you suggest you take care of these pieces?
Oh, that's a good question.
You know? Because sometimes people wear stuff and they kind of, they don't take care of it. Mm-hmm. But I know, how long do you think these would last? Because I'm thinking these are lifetime pieces.
Yes.
But, and how would you care for them after you get them?
Okay. I would say that they can be lifetime pieces, especially the ones from coconut shell and bamboo. And so I would just keep them where you would keep any of your jewelry that you really love. Mm-hmm. Just keep it in a box.
Yeah.
Okay. As for the one with seeds, again, they can last a very long time.
Right.
The only thing is that you would want to polish them every now and again.
Yeah.
You know, just when you would use them.
Yeah.
You can polish them. And I've used like natural shoe polish.
Uh-huh.
It's there. Oh, okay. Okay.
So it's an inexpensive way to care for them. And just keep them away from moisture.
Okay.
Yeah, the seeds.
All right. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Okay, so let's keep on moving, Carla. Please not go too far with Alida's pieces. And then we're going to bring back the girls with some more pieces that they have to show you guys today. Yeah. So
these are also included in your line,
yes,
right?
Ma'am.
With the pieces that Carla was just wearing.
Yes.
So there's some earrings.
Like that shape.
I love the shape of this. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then there's a cross here.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That's really pretty.
Yeah.
And the heart.
Yeah.
The heart is
so I love that. I love that.
Tom,
like
if
that
you're watching, please take note.
That's really pretty. And then another teardrop, but this one's open.
Yes. Cirilla wants to see this one.
Yeah.
I know the lip, not in my, I don't have my really fingernail, not look tough.
No,
yours look better than mine.
Fingernail. Yeah, would you call that a teardrop also?
Yes,
but it's open.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. These are just beautiful, absolutely.
I love the bracelets here, and this one looks like my size, you know.
Right. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Let's see, or maybe not. Okay, but this is gorgeous, Cirilla.
That's bamboo.
Look
at
that,
it's
gorgeous.
That's bamboo?
It's bamboo that I painted and like the sand off.
I love this. Who would have thought you could get something beautiful out of bamboo like that, right? And is this bamboo too?
Yes, it is. That's a natural.
One could fit. There we go. Mm-hmm.
This ring is pretty too.
Please take
off
my ring, Alida.
I hope you're watching.
Alida, take off my ring.
You all have never seen us fight before, but you know.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to give you, or I'll have to wear it on this. It's like when I just got engaged, the ring was a little bit too big, and I refused to take it out, so I just clenched my fingers together the whole time. I was like,
well, it fit me. Everybody saw that. It fit me.
Isn't that beautiful?
It's gorgeous.
Oh my gosh.
It's gorgeous.
Yes, beautiful. All right.
Okay, so.
Okay. So these ones, again, it's the same dark and light.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
It's in leaves, the shape of leaves.
Yes.
So I do different shapes of leaves.
Okay.
This is one of my favorites.
I love that. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
So how long does it take you to make a piece or a set?
Well, when I do make a set, I would make about a dozen to 15 at a time.
Okay.
It depends on the process again, because in cutting the shell, I have someone now that cuts shell for me.
Okay.
So if those shells are already prepared for me, then I would take, I would say about maybe 25 minutes to carve into the into the shell itself.
Okay.
And then I would pass it over to my other helper.
Yeah.
That would polish, mm-hmm. and sand and polish, sorry, because mm-hmm. these are all natural. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So a lot of time and a lot of effort, yes, you know,
a lot of love
goes into every piece. Yeah. Because yeah. I'm That's sure you have to make sure it meets your,
yes.
how you want it, yes. you know?
And we got to take it back to sand again.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, so, and then Rocio.
Yes, the piece that she's wearing, again, it's a piece that I had designed for Unique Belize, and it is made from Guanacaste seeds.
Oh, okay.
Yes, mm-hmm. and again, I combine it with turquoise.
And show your bracelet there, Rocio.
Yeah.
Yes, I do three types of bracelet, mm-hmm. and this one is what I would wear with that designing uh-huh. necklace. And, uh-huh.
and there's earrings?
Yes, we have the earrings, yes.
Yeah. I feel like a kid in a candy store.
I know, you know,
because I do. I we keep saying we love it, but it's true. They're all really nice. It's like you would know which one to get because that one I love. And what I'm noticing as well too that you could wear these pieces casual or also very formal as well.
Yes, so, you can. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can. This one, for example, here, it's doesn't have all that beading. Uh-huh. It's just a string on there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. And then nice. Could you show that one as well,
this
too?
This one. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's very nice. And this one has a matching bracelet, I see.
That.
Or it's similar.
It can be.
Yeah.
I do make matching bracelets, but I would use the bronze wire. This one is silver.
Go. Okay.
Yeah, you could try it on your other hand. So this one hangs, I call it a link. Yeah, this is what this one looks like.
Very nice. Very
Thank you.
All right. Well, girls, we're not going to fire with those pieces, right? Okay, so we will also bring Carla back. Angie has another piece that we want to show you guys as well. And then I don't know if I wanted to get to that piece over there, so.
We do need to take a break.
Do we have to?
Yeah,
I forgot about breaks. Like,
we did.
Who needs a break?
Who needs a break? We're having too much fun.
I forgot about break. Thank you guys for reminding us. Yes.
And we'll be right back.
It's like taking away the chocolate from us. We'll be right back.
Dad, I'll take Boardwalk off your hands for $1,000. It's almost triple.
Nope.
Okay, fine. I'll give you $2,000 plus the utilities. Take it or leave it.
Is that all you got?
Okay. I know you won't refuse this.
What's good barbecue worth to you? Grace barbecue sauce.
Here are some latest samples from Roots and Honors. From
just a glimpse of his glory, just a hint of majesty.
Lord, be my hero.
We
Welcome back to Life Uncommon. We are live here in the studio at Plus TV, and if you're just joining us, you have missed out on some beautiful, beautiful handmade jewelry that is designed right here in Belize. We have Miss Sharondale Humes with us this morning, and we have Carla here again to show off some more of the jewelry. What is Carla wearing?
Carla is wearing a piece from bamboo. And what I did, I used actual flowers and leaves.
Okay.
I stick onto the bamboo and
then
I covered it.
Wow, yes. That's beautiful. Yes. That's beautiful.
Her earrings are just plain natural. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay.
Very lightweight, it seems.
Yeah, it's very light. Mm-hmm. Bamboo is very light. Mm-hmm.
And did we talk about her bracelet already that she has on?
Her bracelet, again, it's just a natural bamboo.
Okay.
Yes. In shape of a leaf.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, it's gorgeous. Mm-hmm. Gorgeous.
I want and Carla to drop off that I said in
model. I know.
Next time, Pastor Boy and me, I'll be model.
And then, so a necklace.
Yes, I also do it in the heart shape.
The heart shape, yeah. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Yeah. You know what I love is it looks like you are designing things that you would wear or that you would want to give away as gifts. So there, it just feels like there's a lot of love in each and every piece.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so let's keep this ball rolling.
Rolling, yeah.
We have with us, all right, come on. While the girls are coming on, we have these as well. So maybe we could touch on these pieces while the girls are coming on.
So, Sharondale, what are these?
Okay, so these again are my version of a candle holder.
Wow.
What I did, I used the bamboo for the inside,
uh-huh.
And the broom, we call it the broom that comes from the coconut palm tree. Most people just throw it away, but I'm the one that goes and collect it. So that's what I use to cover the entire thing. And I sell them as individual pieces or as a set.
Okay. Yeah, because I see you have three different heights here. Yeah, I love this one. What is this one made of?
That one, again, it's a combination of coconut and bamboo. Huh. And again, like a mosaic, I cover it with broken pieces of shell.
Okay.
Wow. So I do it with or without the leaves on it. Yeah.
This
vase, I made it about 4.5 to 5 years ago. I just kept this piece for myself.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Just as a prototype. But I do them in different size and shape as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. See, it would be hard for me to be a businesswoman because I would want to keep it all.
I'm always giving away.
Okay.
Even to the people that buys,
yeah.
I just surprise them and say, hey, you can have this.
That's great. Yeah. So we've got Kelsey and Rocio back. Mm-hmm. And what does...
Mm-hmm. Yes, so Kelsey is wearing... a necklace that I designed from, we call it St. John's seed.
Okay.
And you'll see this type of seed mostly in the southern part of our country. The Mayans, the women, they use it a lot for their jewelry.
And are they naturally that color?
It is naturally that color.
Wow.
Yes, and so I bought the seeds from them.
Okay.
And so that's how I designed one of
the
necklaces. And I also do the little rings to go with it.
Bling, bling.
Bling.
I do earrings as well, but being in a hurry this morning, it kind of slipped. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That's gorgeous.
And for,
what's her name? Rocio, I love this. I love this too.
Yes, her piece.
This is gorgeous.
Thank you. Her piece is done from coconut shell, and I do this in different colors as well.
Oh, nice.
Yes, in red, it looks beautiful as well. In
I bet it does look gorgeous in red.
And in other
shapes.
And
the earrings match.
Yes,
ma'am.
I also make the bracelets. I didn't bring any this morning, but it would have been
similar to one of
that
these.
One?
Yes.
Okay.
And it has the same colors on it.
All right.
Wow.
Well, that
That's
is
beautiful.
Officially... Well, I don't know if I say everything yet, but officially, I think that's my favorite piece out of everything I've seen. I just love that one. Wow. I like Alanine, but that one there, put the love fan that one. beautiful. All right.
Thank you.
Okay, so what else? Because I see bookmarks here as well. Yes. So,
yes, those. Again, they are from bamboo, and just as the necklace that Miss Carlo was wearing, I use actual flowers and leaves in there. And what I write on it can be
customized, right?
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
For these ones, I have Belize and two of.
Yeah.
You could send them to your people in your passport country.
In my passport country, that's right. That is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. And like you said, you can customize the message.
Yes, I can.
Okay.
So we actually have these to give away.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Okay.
They're similar to this design. Has
a
writing on them.
And try find Cirilla. Where is Cirilla?
Yeah.
All right, there we go. So,
and there's the phone numbers on the screen. Yes. What are we going to have them do?
Maybe they should answer a question.
I think that's a good idea.
You know, maybe what name of the raw material, is that the right word, that Sharondale uses to make her pieces, and then you get one of these. Mm-hmm. All right. I remember if you're not on me, I can't remember.
That's right. And so what are these? Did we see these already?
No one has worn them as yet, but Miss Carla can wear a piece.
Okay.
Okay, so maybe if we could, we'll talk about that. Yeah, so if Carla can come on with that piece, and then we could switch spaces.
Okay.
All right, so we got the cue.
Yeah.
We're going to be wrapping up quickly here. So, girls, if you could switch out so Carla can show that piece, that would be wonderful.
Thank you.
And thank you, girls. You were lovely.
Yes,
models.
Very lovely. Thank you so much, Rocio and Kelsey. You did an awesome job.
Yes, they did.
All right.
So this is gorgeous. That's stunning. So
the color is very different.
Yes.
Yes. I designed it just for the Christmas season. Yes. And it is from bamboo.
Okay.
So the beads, they're wooden, but I spread them gold. So you have the extra long, and the one that she's holding in her hand is a little bit shorter.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
It reminds me of those beautiful, is it flamboyant trees?
Yeah.
What are those trees called, right?
Yes. Bright colors.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
It is.
Next to where Black Orchid is, the road is just filled. Uh-huh. It reminds me of those trees when I look at that, the color.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Beautiful piece
again.
Thank you, Carla, for doing that. So, Sharon, okay, so everybody is watching and drooling practically. All right, somebody says, good morning. Those vases are beautiful. Coconut and bamboo at its best. I would like to win it for your daughter. My daughter or your daughter?
I'm sure they mean their daughter.
Because my daughter took it. All right, so, but thank you for texting in. We have several. So if anybody else wants to call in and win, please call in. And you can win yourself one of these, okay? If you tell us where Sharondale comes from, all right? She said that earlier on in the show. Mm-hmm. So I'm making it up as I go.
That works.
All right, so how can people get in touch with you to, you know, view your pieces, to order, to purchase, whatever?
Well, as I said, I reside in Borobudur Village, so.
Okay.
But I have a website at sharondaledesign@wordpress.com.
Okay.
Sharondaledesign@wordpress.com.
Yes.
Okay.
And my phone number, Should I just leave the car?
You could share it, yes. Oh, and then okay. We could also post it up on yes. our Facebook page yes. for you.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, my phone number is 604-2723.
Okay. 604-27.
Yes. I can also be found at the Biltmore. They carry my pieces.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
The Black Orchid Resort also carry my pieces.
Okay. Great. Excellent. So great. People can go to those places to find them, and then if they want a more customized piece too, uh-huh, they yes. could contact you directly. So people, we will be putting up her website on our Facebook page as well for you guys to go and contact her and you know, get something. It's amazing. You won't regret purchasing any of them. Oh, she said she's doing it for my daughter. Thank you very much. I'm sure she will love it. All right. So, okay, well, Sharon, Carla, and Kelsey and Rocio, thank you guys so much for being here and coming, you know, this distance to be with us and sharing just a little bit of the beautiful things that you do. We really appreciate you yes. coming.
Thank you. Yes.
And we wish you all the very best. In the years to come with these pieces, and may God just continue to bless you and give you more ideas.
Yes,
yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, thank you, ladies.
Thank you, ladies.
I mean, beautiful. Look beautiful. At that. That's a shot right there. All right, so don't go anywhere, everybody. We will be right back. Okay.
Dad, I'll take Boardwalk off your hands for $1,000. It's almost triple.
Nope.
Okay, fine. I'll give you $2,000 plus the utilities. Take it or leave it.
Is that all you got?
Okay. I know you won't refuse this.
What's good barbecue worth to you? Grace barbecue sauce.
Here are some latest samples from Roots and Honors.
Just a glimpse of His glory, just a hint of majesty.
Lord be my hero, my hero. Lord be my hero, my hero. Come and be my light, my darkest night.
Bing, bala, bing, 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 bing
Dad, Altec Boardwalk off your hands for $1,000. It's almost triple.
Nope.
Okay, fine. I'll give you $2,000 plus the utilities. Take it or leave it.
Is that all you got?
Okay. I know you won't refuse this.
What's good barbecue worth to you? Grace barbecue sauce.
Here are some latest samples from Roots and Honors. For
just a glimpse of his glory, just a hint of majesty.
Lord be my hero, my hero. Lord be my hero, my hero. Come and be my light, my dark inside.
Life gives you lemons, make a lemonade. Oh, it's a celebration.
Swing bala bing bala billing billing. Swing bala bing bala billing billing.
Here are some latest samples from Roots and Honors.
Just a glimpse of his glory, just a hint of majesty.
Lord be my hero, my hero. Lord be my hero, my hero. Come and be my light, my dark inside.
Life gives you lemons, make a lemonade. Oh, it's a celebration.
Welcome back, everybody.
Oh,
welcome back, everybody. We are live here in the studios of Plus TV, and it is December, one of my favorite months. You know, I love the whole Christmas spirit and the season.
Yeah.
I was thinking about that this morning of how I wish that people would behave the same way they behave all year round during Christmas, because that's the time where I feel like we act more like Christ.
Yes.
During Christmas, because we are considerate of others, we want to share, you know, we reach out. I see people who normally wouldn't give anything giving to stuff. So I was just thinking about that let's try to do it all year round.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
We just had Sharondale Humes that came, you know, all the way from Burl Boom to be with us today. And then we have a very talented, beautiful mommy who is just over the block, over south, that came to be with us this morning to showcase a talent with us, and her name is Ada Brisenio Almendarez, and she's joining us today to tell us about her business that she's working on. So welcome, Ada. Thank you for being here.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
So good to have you with us.
Thank you very much.
Tell us about the name of your business and what you do.
Okay, well, the name of my business is ABris Inspirationals Greeting Cards. And well, I do a wide variety of arts and crafts. However, this year I've decided to just specify and sell myself as a greeting card business.
Okay. Excellent. So, Ada, I was thinking of you when Sharondale was sharing, because she talked about how all of her pieces, like at first she didn't know what to do, you know, and then she just started to get inspiration. Like God would just give her ideas and she would wake up in the morning and couldn't wait to start working on stuff that she had gotten. And I think of you that it's very similar with you, right?
It is, because even this morning I found myself staying up late last night, and I just put on some worship music and I just sat there, and not falling asleep but just being quiet, and I just began to write. You know, I had some work to do. I just began to write, and I realized it was a passion. And even this morning I woke up and I said, God, I cannot do it alone. And if I do it in my own strength, I will fail, because when I try to do it on my own, all my ideas just go.
I just love your designs. I think I bought one of your cards. You've been selling for a while.
Yes, for the past 3 years.
Yeah, so I think the first time was 3 years ago for me that I purchased one of your cards or a set of cards.
Yeah.
So tell us, what did you bring with you?
Okay, well, first of all, they're all, I call them original ideas. Again, they're not from any, I do not like to go on Pinterest, Facebook, or any type of art website to get my ideas. The reason is because I'm selling myself mainly as original.
Right.
And so all of them is just basically ideas that comes from, when I think of, okay, if I put myself, I need to begin to work on my Christmas cards.
Okay.
I begin to see ideas coming like from my head, and that's what I paint, right? And so I have what I call the fireworks, the sparkles, the baby Jesus, the manger set, then an inspiration of what all Christmas is.
Okay.
Then this year I decided to touch on the Belizean theme.
Okay.
You know, I call it a national Christmas. So if Andrea could pick up
this
one.
This one?
Yes.
One? Okay.
And so it's not only the Belizean team national symbols, but it's also a detailed, what I call, with a ribbon on it. So that's an extra
creative
touch.
Yeah.
And so that's one of my main pieces
I'm
selling.
They look like ornaments.
Yes, they do. I love that.
With that, I have a, you know, other, like the Belizean Christmas, I believe it's this one right there.
This one here?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Trying to embrace the Belizean Christmas, and then other ideas that came to mind, and I put together.
I just think that they're just lovely. I love all of them, and then and you know I'm a big fan of your work from in long time, so I can say that. But there, I don't know if you have my favorite one out, but there, I think this one right here. I just love, for some reason when Ada showed it to me, I was like, Ada, I love that. I thought it was so cute with the little baby, in the basket there. I love it. And then she puts these amazing little verses on them, but you could also get them blank if you want to customize that. So tell us about that.
I mainly, apart from doing my own designs for mainly seasons like Christmas, I do personalized and customized cards. So I sell blank cards. I sell with an idea. However, if you want an order with whatever want, then I cater to that as well. Like for instance, I have an order for today that instead of, for the Belizean design, instead of having Merry Christmas, it has Feliz Navidad.
Ooh,
oh, I'm inside, wow. From my casa to your casa type of thing.
Uh-huh.
So
okay.
If you want whatever in the car, then I have it, again, because I have it as a soft copy, I could edit
right.
it and customize it to
okay.
your liking.
Okay. And so, if let's say, what if somebody says, like me, they fall in love with this card and they would love to give this to more than one person, would do you sell in bulk too, or like say per dozen, or how does that work?
Well, I sell them single at $5,
uh-huh.
and then I let's say together all of them, I sell them, that's how many, I think 8 designs.
Uh-huh.
It's like around $30 to $40, but
okay.
again, it all depends on how much you want.
Right.
And
okay.
What
so the
you
more
want.
You buy, you give
yes.
a discount, or
yes,
you take
yes.
off a little bit off.
That's
okay.
Great. That's
so.
Great.
And how long would you say you would give people before they actually get, if they place an order, how long does it take for them to pick up their order?
Well, since I've already have, if they want it how it is
uh-huh.
as I've created them, then it takes 2 to 3 days. However,
okay.
if they want a change to it, then it takes 4 to 5 days.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, and all that right. depends on the amount of work I have to, because sometimes,
right.
sometimes I'm pretty free, so then it allows me more time to
right.
produce more.
Yeah, so,
yeah.
okay, so I know we jumped off into that, but tell us a little bit your inspiration behind even stepping out like this, because I know, like I said before, you're a mom of a beautiful baby girl.
Oh, she is so gorgeous.
How old is she? Two?
Oh, Brianna is 2. She
mm-hmm.
she will be 2.5 January right here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
A chatterbox.
So what inspired you, Ada, to step out into this? Because again, I told you, I just kept thinking about her with Sharondale,
yeah.
because she's a housewife and she says, that's what I love, you know, I
uh-huh.
got that. And to step out into business was a bit difficult for her at first because, you know, she was like, I don't know anything about this. So what inspired you to start making cards and different things?
Well, I love art in a whole.
Mm-hmm.
And then, well, moving on from, you know, not doing anything to having a child, I realized I had to zoom into, you know, specifically what I like to do. And
yeah.
I love to do acrylic painting.
Okay.
Okay.
Right. And so I realized, okay, acrylic painting, I don't really want to sell canvases. So somehow, I don't know where the idea of selling cards came from. So
uh-huh.
I believe it's a God idea.
Definitely.
And I stepped into it. I paint my cards. What I usually do, I paint it, and I do this. I sketch them all.
Okay.
And then afterwards, I scan them,
okay.
edit
okay.
them, then print them. So
okay.
all of them is in this form.
Okay.
And then this is the original. So what I do is just sit down and ideas come to me, I paint,
yeah.
and then I do the rest of the card
okay.
production.
Yeah.
But the inspiration just came from wanting to make a difference, wanting
yeah.
to be more of an example to girls.
Mm-hmm.
I've always felt that I had some form of impact towards girls, and I wanted them to know that you could do what you want, your
yeah.
desires, your dreams
yeah.
is
yeah.
possible, and it's, you know, it's okay to pursue them, and giving it to God will allow him to open a bigger door than what you dream
hmm.
of. Because sometimes I feel so choked up with my dream, I'm just like, oh, I don't know where to do or what to do with it or where to go, right? That sometimes Brian's like, come to bed, and I'm like, no, I need to get this done. I need to get this done. And so, you know, it's just to me, I say, lack of better words, that it consumes me, but it's a good consuming that is just, to me, it's a fire that
yeah.
I just need to
yeah.
put out, and
mm-hmm.
that's what is here is what comes out
yeah.
when I put out that fire.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about the name of your business. What inspired the name?
Okay, well, ABris Inspirationals came from, well, the main thing is ABris.
Mm-hmm.
Well, growing up, I've always struggled with my identity.
Okay.
I'm always Aleida's daughter, Brenda's sister, and I, you know, I was never out there for myself. And so
mm-hmm.
when I got married, Brian, you know, he worked with me, and he's like, okay, now we're going to make a name for yourself.
Mm.
Yeah.
Right? And so bringing out the name ABris is just an identity,
okay.
putting myself
mm-hmm.
under, you're Ada.
Okay.
You're not Brian's wife
okay.
or Brenda's
mm-hmm.
sister any longer. You're
yeah.
Ada. And so that helped me
mm-hmm.
find myself and know that, okay, I'm a child of God, and God wants to
mm-hmm.
put out so much through me.
Yeah,
wow.
I am so glad I asked that question, because I think somebody needed to hear that
yes.
answer.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah.
you know, we do struggle as growing up, I was always, you know, Trisha's daughter, John's sister, that kind of thing. And finding out your own identity, out of that is so important.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So.
I you know what I love about this morning, Alida? We are showcasing talented entrepreneurs, business owners.
Yes.
But it's just amazing how it's more than just that. Like, Sharondale and now Ada, they're speaking words of life to our viewers. And it's true. I feel like people who are watching needed to hear some of the things that they're sharing.
Definitely.
Because one of the things, too, that Sharon was saying, and maybe Ada, you could share a little bit about your thoughts on it, too. She was talking about the parable of the talents, how God gave, Jesus was telling the story of how he gave everybody a certain amount of talent, and what did they do with it?
Yeah.
Some did good with it, and some didn't do anything with it. And so what would you say is, when it comes to maybe the word of God or a verse or something that you hold on to keep you inspired?
Well, to keep me inspired is this verse that says, delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart, right? And when I find out, when I plug myself into what God wants me to do, then my dreams, like, you know, feeling like I have all of this stored up in me, just comes to life.
Yeah,
it just comes to life, and it exists without me have to put in that extra effort to do it on my own. And so delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart.
Yeah,
I love that verse.
I love that verse too.
And I can see that in her work, you know, because you know, she just put some up here, so, you know, but this girl got a lot of ideas, and they just keep getting better and better.
And I just love how open you are, how free you are, listening to what God has to share with you, and then putting it into reality, you know, actually following through with the work. Because so many people get ideas, but not everybody follows through.
Indeed. Yes. And so that's my main encouragement to, whenever you feel like something, I believe that everybody has something in store within them. And it's your, not your responsibility, but more like your responsibility to dig within and say, God, what is my purpose? And when you can find that purpose, when you step forward, you won't have to question, will I impact anyone? That won't be even be in your mind. Because you're stepping forward in God's purpose, the will of God, you know, for your life, then you will automatically do what God wants you to do through your work.
Thank you so much for sharing those words of wisdom, Ada. And tell us how people could get in touch with you to get some cards for Christmas or any special occasion that's coming up. Because I don't know if you have it with you, Ada, but I wanted to show that one. You did a anniversary or a wedding one or something, but she does for anniversary, for birthdays, for
baby showers,
anything you need a card for. So you want to get in touch with her. So Ada, tell us how people
Can have a Facebook page, ABris Inspirationals Art, and so I post up all what I, everything I do on that page. I could be contacted through my Facebook page and also through WhatsApp, which is my phone number, 669-3969, or through my husband's number, 625-0256. And so even through email, abrisinspirationals@gmail.com, and put in your order, and, you know, we work. My idea is, of my card business is cards that will make your heart smile, right? And that's the impact I want to have upon, you know, people when they have my card. And, and when it comes to customization and personalizing cards for people, is bringing your ideas to reality. Because sometimes we're, you know, I have so much idea and I don't know how to bring it to life. And I found out that when people tell me what they want and I produce it, still undermining myself, people's like, wow, I like it. And I'm like, okay, right, I'm taken aback, because I don't, again, I'm not consumed with what I do and it's good and perfect. I'm just like, okay, doing what I believe, you know, I must do. And then people get so, you know, taken aback by it. Then I realize it's not me. Right?
And and I think, and I want to encourage people to support your business, because nowadays I think we're losing that touch of giving a simple card or, right. Or reaching out to people.
Right.
People like something tangible. Even right. for birthdays now, people just right. say, happy birthday on Facebook. And that's it.
Exactly.
I want a card. You know, like, so even things like that. Let's start bringing these yeah. things back. Yes. And pretty soon, you know, you will be able to find Ada's work in other stores around this country.
Definitely.
So you look out for her. Definitely. You will know it's her because at the back of those cards, mm-hmm. it will have Made in Belize by Ada, ABris Inspirational.
Yes.
So please get in touch with her. We will be putting her information on our Facebook page as well to remind you guys to check her out for Christmas. Why go and buy cards that has snow and different things than
right,
when you can get a
right.
card right here in
yeah.
Belize.
Yeah.
All right?
And these are just absolutely gorgeous mm-hmm. treasures. Yeah.
Well, Ada, any final thing you would like to share with us before we go today?
Okay, well, I just, you know, want to encourage everybody to tap into what God has for you. Don't miss God's plan for your life and don't delay it. The sooner you tap into what God has for you, the better life becomes and the happier you will be. And to see God work in our lives, I think that's the ultimate goal.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
to live a fulfilled life.
Definitely, yeah. definitely. So don't delay. Tap into it now. Yeah.
All right. These are women, both of these women today are great examples of women living that uncommon life
yes.
that we talk about all
I
the time.
I think so. Yes. Definitely. Well, we are so excited about today's show and how it's going to impact your life. And so we do have some
thank yous.
Yes.
I stopped talking because like, that your department.
So I want to say thank you to Grace Kennedy to Belize and to Roots and Honor Records. Thank you so much to Sharondale Humes, who was with us earlier,
mm-hmm.
and to Ada of ABris Inspirationals. Thank you to everybody that's watching. Thank you, Cirillo, and thank you, Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
Did I miss anybody? I got it all.
And our
lovely models we
mm-hmm.
had with us this morning.
Yes.
We had Kelsey and Rocio mm-hmm. and Carla. So this has just been a really great show.
Yes, really good. I'm
yeah.
really happy that we got to pull it together.
Definitely,
yeah.
definitely. And I know we did our Inspirational Woman last week, but I've been inspired.
We got two
you know,
more
like,
today. Yes.
Exactly, we got
yeah.
two more today.
And our studio is filled with two other women behind
yeah.
the scenes that I also know to be inspirational women. And I want to say thank you as well to LG Jewelry because
yes.
she has been a loyal supporter
yes.
of our show.
Yes.
And she sponsored our jewelry pieces
jewelry.
For today.
So
look at how beautiful that
yeah.
is. Everybody, come on, Cirillo. Come on, my quick boss, a little bit more. I know you're tired of this show.
Yeah, I know.
Wait,
but,
I'm thinking
yeah.
I'm in my turn. How
no,
you
he already showed
hand?
You.
But
you
I don't walk close. Stop. Cause Cirillo, yeah, see how
the,
beautiful is
yes.
that, right? Okay, and
it
see,
is.
I did do the wrong thing today, but
yeah. Oh well, you have Christmas on too.
I got the Christmas here and the one to match here.
Yeah.
yeah.
yeah. And the
oh
yes,
and
the
earring to match.
Oh, she's got her. Yeah, you got to show mine.
Right, show
as well.
Anita.
Where are you? Got it. There we go. Yeah. Oh,
beautiful
so,
pieces
yes.
by LG Jewelry as
yeah.
well. Another local Belizean woman that's doing great things.
Great things. Great things. So,
Wigan.
Thank you for being with us. See you next
Bye.
Week.
Next week is our Christmas finale,
yes.
people. So make sure you tune in. You don't want to miss it.
Bye.